Mike. Let's mainly focus on this camera for the most part.
What if I'm looking at this camera and they're all looking at filming. You? It's gonna look make me look like I'm a dumb.
Talking.
I'm on my own.
Are we filming?
We're used to that, Tom.
Are we filming?
We also say, no problem, right?
Are we done? All right, I'm Smokin' Ed Curry. I'm the president, owner, mad scientist, and chef at the Pucker Butt Pepper Company. And the sun's out, and the guns are out.
Wow, he did it, didn't he?
I did. We just did an installment of the Reaper Grow video just, 4 days ago, okay? And we wanted to give you an update. We've had a few questions. So one of the main ones was, what happens if you grow a peewee? Okay, so we're going to put a peewee in a pot. Brett, tell them what happens when you grow a peewee.
Well, you'll have to harden it off for sure. Okay. You'll have to definitely shade, then bring it in the sun. You'll have to do that get to watch it, because these things will evaporate in full sun. It'll be just basically toast.
And just so you know, this guy and this guy were planted on the same day.
Let's see, look at here. Okay. See a little guy there? Yeah.
Yeah.
There's your proof right there, buddy.
Never give up on your seeds.
Never.
Never.
And if you're going to go this small, you're going to want to bring your dirt level up.
Yeah, why is that?
Just because of the sun. Yeah, you don't want the shadow. You're going below grade there. I mean, you got to be careful with these guys, because they'll definitely want to fall apart. It's like almost like a ballet here. And you don't have a whole lot of roots, so this low, you kind of, shade. So what you want to do really is you want to bring a little more dirt in the situation. Tom has expertly prepared our dirt. Pretty much watered the dirt all the way through. You see that dry stuff is just going to soak the moisture out. So when you plant this guy, you're going to make sure you come back and water this guy. So you're going to want to come and be a little bit higher up. I don't like to go this small.
I don't like to either.
But if you do have a peewee and you're like, hey, I want to get this thing transplanted, and transplanting does stimulate growth. It does. We've seen plants go from this size. Like, you can, just last week when we transplanted some, actually we have them.
We'll show you in a
minute. Yeah, we'll show you in a minute what they look like. So.
But what we're going to do is all these different sizes, we're going to get into pots. Okay. So, it's never too late. Today is what, the 20?
Today's 25th, right?
25th, right. Okay. So 25th of May, we're putting stuff into pots.
Yeah.
Now remember the other day, these were full of aphids. Look at this. Just a few now.
Just a few now?
Yeah, guess what? I had some green lacewing eggs. I released them in here. The aphid problem is going away.
And sometimes when you water, the dirt will settle. You can always top it off. And you can even plant the first layer of branches if you want to. I mean, you can.
And one thing I'll show you with the ones we just transplanted, when was it, last Friday?
Mm-hmm.
They're looking beautiful. People ask about fertilizing. One of the reasons we use the Performance Organics is it's going to fertilize the plants. It gives them everything they need for their first, 30 to 60 days. I like to, after about 30 days, add a little bit of fish emulsion.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that just
can't go wrong.
Greens them up, pops them up. A little bit after that, some CalMag. Greens them up, pops them up. That's what I like to do.
You can get 10% CalMag, that's great.
Oh, that's awesome.
Because they're calcium, our dirt here in the south is a little more acidic, and you can't give them enough calcium. So.
Look, remember?
Yep.
Full of aphids, green lace.
They definitely,
there's a white spot.
There's a few, but not
just
not
a
many.
Couple. And look, again, we have a little peewee and a grown-up plant. Never, ever, ever give up on your seeds.
Mm-hmm. Now, this one just dropped its leaf. Is that normal, Ed?
That's normal. And actually, when we show people what we do with our plants, we're going to be trimming some bottom leaves.
Uh-oh, we're going to show them all the secrets, Ed?
Not all the secrets, but some of them.
Not the super secrets.
We want people to have success, Tom. We want them to have success.
We know the struggle.
Know the struggle. So all the mistakes we had, you're going to learn from them.
Hey, what if you had, say, a plant that's in a tray or a little pod that's root-bound? What would you do with it?
If it's root-bound, what I do is I just scrunch it.
Yep.
And free up those roots.
Right.
and then plant it into the dirt.
I think we have some down here. I don't want to step off camera, but we do have some that are root bound.
You want to get one that's root bound and show them?
Well, these aren't as root bound as I thought they would be, but they're pretty good size. But what you would do is you would just take them and you would break that up, right?
Yep, just break it up a little.
Break it up. So these are really still looking pretty good. So, but all you have to do, break it loose. Yeah. So.
All right, so we have one more plant to plant, another peewee, but it's a little bit bigger, and we're going to show you what happens to that. Thank you, Tom.
I'm going to have to open this up the big bag.
Now, this one's good.
And the best way is to squeeze it and just turn it upside down and let it drop. You don't have to try to pull it out by the plant itself. That would just pop right out. So not a whole lot of root system.
Well, there's a lot of roots. This
I mean, it's not as, you know.
Yeah, because it's a little baby.
It's a little baby guy, yeah.
What a professional.
I think he's in the running for the hands there, too.
So we showed you the one plant. Oh, maybe we should bring that on camera. How about we show him? Remember the plant that was dead? That we trimmed a little, all the leaves were shriveled up, and I said, just water it. Look, we trimmed it, we watered it. Look at all the new growth. Look at how beautiful those leaves that were all shriveled up were. This plant is gonna produce. And everywhere we trimmed, there's new growth coming out. So, this one's gonna produce, it's gonna produce really well, and we're gonna eat some peppers off this first thing. Okay, the first pepper that comes off, Tom's going to eat it after rubbing it in his eye.
I cannot believe how great this plant looks.
In 4 days.
It was so pitiful.
Now, Ed, now I know we weren't planning on overwintering this plant. It just kind of overwintered
on itself. No, it overwintered by itself.
If we were going to overwinter it, where would you have clipped it back at?
Well, on this one, it would have been difficult to say because there were four or three stalks coming out, but I would have gone to here on all three stalks, kept it about a foot tall, and left the growth below it so that it could absorb some energy from the sun.
Now, once it starts dying back, is that why those stalks died all the way back to there?
Yeah, because I didn't trim it because we were going to trash it.
Yeah,
but it wants to live, so we're going to allow it to produce fruit. So, we showed you 10 days ago when we were planting these. I wanted to show you the difference between, a lot of people say they use those peat pots. This tray is full of peat pots. All right, as you can see, right now we only have 4 seeds popped. The same exact seeds in the Miracle-Gro potting soil, we're at about 23% right now, 25, 26, 27% germination. So this is the reason I don't use peat. It takes the seeds a lot longer to germinate. We're getting some popping out of the peat. We got 10 days. Right now, the reapers, which actually we didn't plant until 8 days ago, the reapers are at 82% germination. Chocolate Scotch Bonnets are at 50. CP115 is at 20 after 8 days. But as you can see, 10 days down, all the peppers are starting to pop. We've done nothing but water these and left them in the greenhouse. The plants we transplanted last Friday, look at those. They're all growing, and they're growing good. And I wanted to show you, see this circle right here? Brett said earlier, you can bury the leaves. What we're gonna do with these plants, once they get about this tall, is we're gonna top them off. We're gonna put soil in all the way up to this circle. That's gonna stimulate more root growth and make for a healthier plant. We're gonna use drip irrigation, and we'll show you all that later. But all you need is a hose with a nice, gentle wand on it. If you're flowing at a high rate, the seeds pop out, you damage the plants. Flow at a low rate, spend twice as much time, and you're gonna get perfect plants. This is the window tray. The window tray is looking pretty good, and guess what? I'm taking it to my house. And we're going to do a little video at my house of transplanting into the pots that me and Tom set up with the deer fence. And then I'm going to show you what happens with deer and a deer fence. Okay, because my deer fence is only about, what, 4 foot tall? When the plants get over 4 foot tall, the deer eat them. Okay, but we get good amount of pods from it. So, it's just a quick update. I hope you enjoyed this. God bless you. Be kind to one another. Okay, if you see anything negative happening out there, do something to change it into a positive. Help one another. You see an old lady at the grocery store? I saw an old lady who couldn't even push her cart. She had so much in it. I pushed her cart for her. I loaded her groceries. All right? Just do something nice for someone else, and we can change the world one person at a time. Good luck with your peppers. Send any questions you have to staff@puckerbuttpeppercompany.com or brandon@puckerbuttpeppercompany.com. He'd love to answer your questions. He's just going to turn around and ask me. I love you guys. Take care. Bye-bye.
Suns out, guns out.
We're going to the gun show today.
Look at that.
Boys.
Look at it.
Now, I just want to say, the only reason these videos are coming out is because of Dark's hard work. He's doing a good job for a semi-pro.
Thank you, man.
He needs to follow direction a little more, but he's really doing a good job.
You're doing a great job.
I just gave you an Oreo the way you like it.
Dude, you did awesome.
Yeah.
That was the best.
It was.
I'm going to go make more videos.
Okay.
Here, mic check, right check, 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 check. Womp, 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 womp. All right. So all right. Charlie Brown's teacher.
What do you think of all this new stuff?
I'm jealous. I see. No.
You know I'm always jelly at Dark. He's my hero, and I just want to be like him, and that's why I pick on him.
Every time he gets a new toy, it gets better and better.
Better,
so it's a good investment.
But the camera's only as good as the operator.
Yeah, you know, you can't make... I got to can't say it.
You can't make chicken stuff out of chicken salad.
Chicken stuff, that's right.
Nah, he does a good job.
Nah, you do a good job.
Yeah. Do you remember how angry the guys from Netflix were getting?
Yes.
Oh, they were. Like, can you stop that? It's like, oh, yeah, hold on. Let me call.
We're going to call. Hey, change the runway. Ed's filming.